What's going on YouTube? Jake here with Vendor Visuals, and today we're going to be discussing how to create this trippy freeze transition effect in Adobe Premiere Pro. Now, I've seen a couple other people attempt to recreate this effect, but most of the tutorials I've seen on YouTube also use Adobe Photoshop to make this effect, but today we're just going to use Premiere Pro to replicate this effect. Don't need Photoshop, you don't need any other software, all you need is Premiere Pro. So let's jump right into the video. Here is the transition we're going to make. So let's just watch it once. D-Mac on the fucking track. So the first thing you want to do is drag your second clip above your first clip. Not by much, just a few frames. So we'll just go ahead and drag it over there. And now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go all the way to this cut where this cut is going to happen. So as you can see, if I zoom in here, it's happening right here. And I'm just gonna start taking screenshots. So we're just gonna take a screenshot using this export frame button right here. If you don't see the export frame button right there, hit this plus, all the buttons will pop up and you can just drag it onto this toolbar. What we can do is just hit this. So we'll go ahead and call this first and make sure you have the import into project selected. That will make sure it imports directly into our project panel over here. So we're just gonna hit okay. Now we're gonna go three frames to the left. One, two, three. We're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna call this one second, hit okay. We're gonna go three more frames, one, two, three, call this one third, and then we're gonna go three more frames and call this one fourth. So we're just gonna delete this excess footage over top. And now you can see over in our project panel, we have first, second, third, and fourth already imported. So what you wanna do before you drag any of these screenshots in is come up to Premiere Pro, go to preferences, go to timeline, and make sure that your still image duration is set at three frames. So we're just gonna hit okay. This ensures that whenever we drag a picture into the timeline, it's going to last for three frames exactly. So we're just gonna go ahead and drag our first one in. And if I zoom into it, you can see that it's three frames. So one, two, three. So it lasts for three frames, perfect. So now we're gonna go second right here, third, and number four. So now if I play this back, we're going to have the stutter effect, right? So check this out. You see how it kind of stutters and then goes smooth motion? So this is perfect. So now what I like to do is import an overlay to put over this to give it some texture. So I've already got this texture here, which if I drag it up into my source panel, you can see it's got scratches all over it, which if we just drag this over top of our screenshots, it's just gonna be a black screen, right? So what we need to do is click our texture, go down to blend mode and click on screen. Now you can get these textures basically anywhere online if you just Google texture overlays or scratch overlays. You just wanna make sure it basically has a black background so that you can easily change the opacity mode to screen to get rid of the black background. So now you can see we have some texture, which is awesome. So now what we wanna do is just cut this texture with each of these screen grabs. And we're just gonna nest each one of these into their own layer. So we're just gonna take each one, right click and hit nest, highlight both, right click, hit nest. So this is basically just telling Premiere Pro, hey, I wanted to combine both of these layers into one layer. So now what you can do is come over here to your effects, type in Lumetri color right here, it'll pop up. And now we can give our cutouts some color correction. So this was a really cold day, so I actually want these to kind of be cold and washed out. And so we're gonna decrease the saturation a little bit. We took the temperature down a little bit. Maybe we'll increase the contrast a little bit. You know, you can play around with this as much as you want. If I turn this Lumetri color off, you can see what a difference it makes on and off there. So what you do from here is just copy paste this Lumetri color, holding Command C onto your other layers here that we've cut out. So they're all the same color. Now comes the fun part. We're gonna come to our first layer here and we're gonna open up our opacity drop down, and then we're gonna just select this pen tool right here and we're just gonna trace around kind of like the bottom area of where he starts to come into the frame, just like that. Now you wanna make sure that you get all the way to the bottom here and boom. You can see we've now created a mask which only takes that part of the image. We're gonna go ahead and decrease the mask feather all the way. And now we have the first frame cut out. So now what we need to do is basically the same thing for the rest of these. So the next one, we're gonna go over here, take the pen tool, go up a little higher. So, you know, we'll go up to maybe like his chest area. We'll kind of cut around him over there, make sure that we get the bottom again. Boom, there's number two. Now number three, Same thing, motion, pen tool, chasing. Now we got most of his body in there. By the time the last one comes in, we'll have basically the entire body. That's good. Make sure these feathers are at zero, which I'm not sure this one is, so we're just gonna turn that one down to zero too. Now for the last one, we're gonna come back up here to opacity, pen tool it. You know how it is. So now we got them all traced. So sick. Boom, you know, tweak them out a little bit. Do whatever you feel is right. Now, this is basically a really quick way to do this effect. Obviously, you can spend a lot of time doing the masking and, you know, the texture finding and the color correction and all this. But for this example, it's really quick. It's really easy. It does not take that much time to do it. And if you're gonna do it really well, it doesn't take much longer than this tutorial. So check it out. And there it is, easy as that. So that is it, guys. I appreciate you guys tuning in to my tutorial. Let me know in the comments what type of creative projects you guys are working on this week. Could be music videos, could be wedding videos, could be YouTube videos, could be anything. Let me know down below. I'm really interested to hear what you guys have to say. And if you're a video editor who is looking to add some extra sauce to their visuals, check out my website, ventervisuals.com. I got overlays, transitions, light leaks, and a bunch of other stuff on there, all of which you can try completely for free. So check it out. I'll include a link down below in the description. And I'm really looking forward to this week's series of videos. So if you're interested in tagging along and helping me grow this community, definitely consider hitting that subscribe button as well. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.